Some days we feel like supermom, handling it all just right. The house and the kids and the job. But eventually, when we have too many demands, it's going to take a toll. And I interviewed a woman recently who admitted the toll that it's taking on her. She knows it's having a detrimental impact, and she told me what she needs to do about it. I'm Diane Mocha. Welcome to Working Mom Warrior, where mothers of all different backgrounds share the ups and downs and hacks of juggling career and kids. We do this so that you can learn from the successes and failures of others and relate to them, and that gives you more inspiration to keep going, and you know that the job you're doing as a mother and professional is good enough, even if it's not perfect. So just recently, I met a mom who told me about so many things she was doing, I could not believe it. I mean, she was taking care of elderly parents, in addition to cooking homemade meals every day and working full-time. She had another job. She had too much going on. But she told me she could handle it all until eventually, further into the interview, she admitted what was going wrong and she knew what she needed to do to make it better.
I have two jobs. So one part-time job is a preschool teacher. The other part-time job, I take care of a senior. So it's my father. So I work Asian Metropolitan. That's my second part-time job. So I work 12 hours a day.
Working 12 hours a day?
Yes, I do. I don't have time for myself at all.
When do you even see your child?
I mean, the summer I can, but when it's school, I'm not able to see him. Once I come home like around 7 o'clock, I can't see him more. I cannot sit with him more because I have other responsibility. I have in-laws at my home. I have other family I take care of it. So we have six family in a home. So I take care of everybody.
Six family members?
Yes.
In your home?
Yes.
And you take care of them?
Yes, everyone.
So you're working like 24 hours a day.
Got it. But still I'm smiley.
I was just going to say, you don't even look tired.
Yes, thank you.
How do you manage all that without, you know, running away or saying, I can't take this anymore?
Once in a while I get frustrated because once in a while you need something. We always take some vacation too. But still, when I come home, I'd be like, oh, you know. So, yeah, that's how I'm looking for something to work from home so I don't need to go preschool.
Who makes the meals at your home?
Myself, every single day, twice a day, like morning, lunch, and evening dinner, every day.
How do you make them when you're not even there?
Yeah, because I work from home like 4 hours with my dad. That time I prepare the meal for him and meal for everyone.
While you're taking care of him?
Yes, exactly.
Okay. Do you even get to enjoy those meals with the family?
Not at all. Because I don't have time to sit with them. But they, you know, I always like to feed them first, then I meet.
And you're making sure this is homemade, healthy food?
Yes, absolutely.
No, not just ordering pizza?
Not at all. And Indian food, you know how much it will take longer.
So you're making traditional food?
Yes, it is. Every day. Once a while, yes.
And who does the schedule for the kid? You have one child.
Everything myself. Or my husband helps too when he's at home. So when he's at home, he takes care of his, you know, all the other activities, taking him over there, bringing him back, you know. But the homework part, all this part, I take care of it.
And you have to tell your husband where he needs to go, or does he know the schedule?
He knows the schedule, that's yes.
So are the weekends less hectic, or are you still running around?
7 days a week, I have everything same for me. Because weekends, my husband out of town, so we don't have time together. In weekdays, I'm busy, so we don't have time together. So it's been crazy life, yeah.
How do you sustain your marriage when you're both so busy and worn out?
I know, it's hard, but sometimes it's part of your life, you know?
So all of this running around, do you feel you have to work this much? Is it something that you want to do? Are you driven? Do you need the income?
I'm not forcing myself, but that's I like it. That's my personality, helpful. I like to be helped more, like social, whatever. Not only home, outside if I have time. I go feed starving children. I do a lot of voluntary work if I can. So that way my kid can learn, like, you know, why it's important.
So you're an overachiever.
Yes.
You're a perfectionist.
Yes, you do.
Okay. Yeah. And how much sleep do you get?
3-4 hours.
3-4 hours or five?
5 hours. Max is five, yeah.
Aren't you feeling at times that you're just exhausted and you can't think straight?
I do. Sometimes I feel tired. Sometimes I need like massages every day. I feel like it. But now I feel like I'm getting old. My body is hurting. I have so much going on, like, you know, pain and here and there. That time I feel like, oh, because of a lot of work, a lot of stress. So probably I'm going to cut some of my hours for work or something.
was just going to say, 3-4 hours a night, for the vast majority of people, that will impact your health in the long run.
I know, exactly.
Do you think you're taking care of your health as well as you should?
No, I don't.
So that's what's kind of fallen by the wayside, is your own health.
Yes, yes, that's true. I have to take care of myself, otherwise I cannot do other people, you know.
No one's going to tell you that, probably.
Yes, I know, that's true.
But I'm telling you.
Hope is the best. So we see, you know, next time when you're taking interview, I will definitely let you know more.
The more good positive things.
Yes, absolutely.
Because, so do you at least go to your doctor's appointments every year?
I do regularly, but once in a while, I always worry about the insurance. So right now that I have a situation going on, a couple of bills that I'm not supposed to pay and I have to pay, you know, kind of things. So I always worried if I go there, if after all the insurance, having so many issues going on, is so that's also part of my health. Like, I like to go, but sometimes I feel like, oh, if I go, I get a bill for that much, you know, so I don't go.
you know what they say on the airplane? Yeah. Put your mask on first. Yeah. You got to take care of your health. If your kid sees you're not taking care of your health, then you're not being the role model you want to be.
Yes.
And it will catch up to you. Yeah. You've been going all these years, but you can't do that forever.
Yeah. Absolutely.
So but if you cut back on some of the hours.
Yes, I have to do it, and I'm planning to do it, so that way accordingly I can stay my life too.
So if you were able to teach from home, like one of these online places,
yes,
that would be better, right?
Yes, I'm definitely looking for something from home, so that way I can spend some time myself, you know.
And I think that will improve your health, because you said you think you need to kind of drop the teaching. You probably like it, right? It's hard to drop anything.
I know.
I had 7 part-time jobs once, and I said, no, too many directions going.
That's true. I agree that. Thank you so much. Yep.
I hope Jawnika gave you some inspiration to get more sleep and take care of your health. And I want you to get other tips and insights from my next video. So click on that and subscribe to Working Mom Warrior, because we want you to join our tribe of girlfriends.